We often travel to visit places, experience magical scenery, and maybe glance at wildlife. But some people move to destinations for sexual needs. In the international context, this is sex tourism, which is being attributed to the high HIV-positive cases in Western Uganda. A recent report shows that in Imbara district alone, HIV prevalence stands at 9.6%, affecting mostly women and young girls at 11.6% and the male at 7.5%. Benson Mohindo, the head of programs Reach a Hand Uganda, has revealed that sex tourism is fueling high HIV prevalence rates in Bara, Rampara, and Fort Portal. Mohindo made the comments while speaking to locals who attended balazas that were organized by Reach a Hand Uganda in partnership with Vision Group as an intervention to curb resurgence of HIV cases in the areas.
It's now being observed in some of the towns like Barara and Koto, where people are driving to come from Kampala and elsewhere to come to, you know, just have pleasure with women in this district. And we are saying this is a vice that is increasing the HIV or the new cases of HIV in this district. So we urge people to live responsibly.
Assistant Inspector of Police Nyongera Francis, the Community Liaison's Officer, Rampara District, attributes the increasing cases of HIV to culture, which is fading away, and now people feel comfortable engaging in sexual networks.
In our age, someone to marry someone's daughter, their parents could move and go to the parents of the girl and report that they are the one who have what? Their daughter. But these days, a girl is the one to go and introduce herself on their parents that I got my friend somewhere. So I am bringing that my friend in such a day.
During the balaza, locals attributed the increasing cases of HIV to poverty and infidelity. Many women are jobless, so when they get someone who has money, automatically they will give in minus knowing the status, and as a result they end up getting HIV. Our men are moving here and there, taking all sorts of energy drinks and drugs. At our age, you can't manage all that energy, and at the end they start accusing us that we don't care, so they look out for other partners. Local leaders have asked government through the Minister of Health to embark on setting up community-based ART clinics at every parish in all the districts. They believe the model, once scaled up to all parishes, will improve HIV prevention in the area by extending integrated services for HIV testing and counseling and other related illnesses nearer to the people, and eventually help reduce the scourge of HIV in the area.
We also request that health center fees also be upgraded to health center force, so that services come closer.
About 1.5 million heterosexual Ugandans are HIV positive. Yesterday, Uganda joined the rest of the world to commemorate World AIDS Day. This year's celebrations were marked under the theme, Let Communities Lead, which is emphasizing the pivotal role of communities in the global fight against HIV and AIDS. Report compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.